Anita, and I'm going to be presenting an analysis of the biblical allusions in 100 Years of Solitude. 100 Years of Solitude, written by Gabriel Garcia Marquez, details the story of the Buendia family over the course of 100 years in Macondo. Garcia Marquez's rich writing style is evident throughout the novel, as his narrative is replete with numerous literary devices and unique literary techniques. One such technique incorporated in his novel is the inclusion of numerous allusions to the Christian Bible. These biblical allusions, including references to Eden, the tree of knowledge, Christ, Noah's flood, and the cyclical nature of time, serve to emphasize and make more relatable the major themes of the novel, as well as support the idea that the novel can be seen as the Book of Macondo. The first major biblical allusion that we see in this novel is the idea that Macondo serves as a representation for the Garden of Eden. The very first description that we have of the village describes it as built on the bank of a river of clear water that ran along a bed of polished stones, which were white and enormous, like prehistoric eggs. The world was so recent that many things lacked names, and in order to indicate them, it was necessary to point. So this quote shows how Macondo was built when the world was so recent, or brand new, just as the Garden of Eden was built by God, where the world was brand new as well. The book of Genesis in the Bible says, "Now the Lord God had formed out of the ground all the wild animals and all the birds in the sky. He brought them to the man to see what he would name them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name." So this quote shows how in the Garden of Eden, objects lack names, just as they did in Macondo, and thus heightens the parallel between the two. We know from the novel that Jose Arcadio Buendia, or Jab, and Ursula were the founders of Macondo. Garcia Marquez also says that they became the first mortals to see the western slopes of the mountain range. From the cloudy summit, they saw an immense aquatic expanse of the Great Swamp as it spread out toward the other side of the world, and there they founded the village. So just as Adam and later on Eve would become the first mortals to see the Garden of Eden, Jose Arcadio Buendia and Ursula were the first mortals to witness Macondo. It's important to understand exactly how and why Garcia Marquez incorporates this allusion throughout his novel. By comparing Macondo to the Garden of Eden, Garcia Marquez is emphasizing the innocence of the initial Macondo. Just as the Garden of Eden was a picture of innocence when God first created it, Macondo was as well before all these foreigners and new technologies arrived to corrupt it. Garcia Marquez achieves this comparison by carefully choosing his language. Phrases such as, "The world was so recent, prehistoric eggs, and they became the first mortals," remind readers of the story of Genesis in the Bible and thus heighten the parallel between the two. This allusion also makes the setting more relatable for readers because many readers are likely familiar with the story of the Garden of Eden. The next major biblical allusion that we see in the novel is the idea that Melquiades the gypsy serves as a representation for the tree of knowledge of good and evil. The story in the Bible says that God planted this tree of knowledge of good and evil, pictured here in the Garden of Eden, and he specifically told Adam and Eve not to take any fruit from this tree, even though it looks very tempting. Melquiades serves as a representation for this tree because he brings to Macondo all sorts of new and tempting technologies, and he persuades Jab to buy them and use them. It is said that Melquiades and the gypsies brought magnets, then they brought a telescope and a magnifying glass the size of a drum. Jose Arcadio Buendia was completely absorbed in his tactical experiments with the abnegation of a scientist and even at the risk of his own life. And this shows just how much of an impact Melquiades' technologies had on Jab. The story in the Bible continues to say that a snake in the Garden of Eden persuaded Eve to pick an apple from this tree, and as a result, God punished Adam and Eve by banishing them from the Garden of Eden, and he also punished them with spiritual death. So just as Adam and Eve were punished in the Bible, Jose Arcadio Buendia is also punished for his excessive thirst for knowledge by being tied to a tree. Garcia Marquez says, 10 men were needed to get him down, 14 to tie him up, 20 to drag him to the chestnut tree in the courtyard, where they left him tied up, barking in the strange language and giving off a green froth at the mouth. So essentially, Jab's excessive thirst for knowledge led him to being tied to a tree, which perhaps served as a representation for the tree of knowledge whose fruit he dared to eat in the first place. By using Melquiades as a representation for the tree of knowledge of good and evil, Garcia Marquez is emphasizing his viewpoint that technologies can actually be detrimental to society and can lead to corruption. Indeed, Melquiades is bringing of these new technologies ultimately drives Jab crazy, and later on in the story, technologies are seen to lead to all sorts of corruption of the innocence of Makondo. This allusion also highlights the irony of Jab's punishment, because his yearning to take fruit from this tree of knowledge leads him to being quite literally tied to the tree itself. Finally, this allusion makes the idea of temptation more relatable for readers. One of the arguably biggest biblical allusions we see in the novel is the idea that Colonel Aureliano Buendia, or Cab, serves as a Christ figure. Garcia Marquez says that Colonel Aureliano Buendia organized 32 armed uprisings, and he lost them all. He survived 14 attempts on his life, 73 ambushes, and a firing squad. So this quote shows how Cab was fighting for the good of the people, and he also managed to survive numerous attempts on his life. And this reminds readers of Christ, because Christ was also working for the good of the people, and he managed to survive attempts on his life as well, because he was resurrected after being crucified, as this quote from the Bible shows. Garcia Marquez describes Cab's death on page 267 of the novel by saying, "He pulled his head between his shoulders like a baby chick and remained motionless with his forehead against the trunk of the chestnut tree." The image that comes to mind upon reading this description is that Cab died with his head hanging down a little bit and against the bark of the tree, which is quite literally a piece of wood. And this reminds readers of Christ because, as seen in this picture over here, Christ also dies with his head hanging down a little bit and against a piece of wood. By comparing Colonel Aureliano Buendia to a Christ figure, Garcia Marquez is further imposing on the reader the importance of the colonel to the story. By depicting Cab as fighting for the good of the people and having thwarted death numerous times, he is reminding the readers of Christ and thus enhancing the importance of Colonel Aureliano Buendia to the story. Garcia Marquez achieves this comparison by choosing his language carefully. For example, Cab could have died anywhere, but Garcia Marquez specifically chose for him to die the way he did, with his head hanging down a little bit and against a piece of wood, and this purposefully furthers the allusion to Christ. Also, this expands upon the idea that all the inhabitants of Makondo serve as a representation for humanity, and a Christ figure, or Cab, emerges from within them. One of the major stories of the book of Genesis in the Bible is the story of Noah's flood. And in chapter 6 of the book of Genesis, this is described as, "God saw how corrupt the earth had become. All the people on earth had corrupted their ways. So God said to Noah, 'I'm going to put an end to all people, for the earth is filled with violence because of them. And rain fell on the earth 40 days and 40 nights.'" So essentially, God saw how wicked the humans had become, and he thus summoned this massive rainstorm upon the earth to rid the humans of this wickedness. And a similar phenomenon is seen in the novel 100 Years of Solitude, and this is described as, "It rained for 4 years, 11 months, and 2 days. The sky crumbled into a set of destructive storms, and out of the north came hurricanes that scattered roofs about and knocked down walls and uprooted every last plant of the banana groves." So just as the flood in the Bible serves to wash away the wickedness of the human race, the flood in the novel serves to wash away the corruption that had come to Makondo as a result of the banana plantations and the banana massacre. By incorporating this flood of biblical proportions in his novel, Garcia Marquez is emphasizing the fact that the rain serves to wash away the corruptions, and he is also making clear to the readers what purpose it serves in the story. He uses various literary techniques to stress the length and quantity of the rain and make sure that readers are aware that it is of biblical proportions. For example, at one point he says, "The air was so damp that fish would have been able to swim through it." The last biblical allusion that I'm going to touch on is the idea that time is of a cyclical nature, both in the Bible and in the novel 100 Years of Solitude. The very last quote from the novel 100 Years of Solitude says, "It was foreseen that the city of mirrors would be wiped out by the wind and exiled from the memory of men at the precise moment when Aureliano Babylonia would finish deciphering the parchments, and that everything written on them was unrepeatable, since time immemorial and forevermore, because races condemned to 100 years of solitude did not have a second opportunity on earth." And what this quote is essentially saying is that Makondo is to be completely wiped out after Aureliano finishes reading the parchments, and then presumably the cycle is to repeat itself over again, And a similar idea is seen in the Bible, because the Bible says, when the 1,000 years are ended, Satan will be released from his prison, and then presumably the cycle is to start all over again. The Bible also emphasizes the idea that humans must undergo this repeated cycle of punishment and destruction until they learn to resist all sinful temptations. And we see this in the novel 100 Years as well, with the Buendia family serving as a representation for all of humanity. I think the quote that most embodies this idea that time is cyclical is seen on page 335 of the novel. Once again, Ursula shouted with the evidence that time was not passing as she had just admitted, but that it was turning in a circle. By including the idea that time is of a cyclical nature in his novel 100 Years of Solitude, Garcia Marquez is furthering the idea that his novel can be seen as the Book of Macondo, or the Bible for Macondo. The idea that time is cyclical partially manifests in the characters themselves, because as seen in this family tree over here, most or all of the Buendia family members are named after a previous family member, and even personality traits are repeated because, for example, most of the Aurelianos are very solitary in nature. The idea that time is cyclical is even seen in the technologies. The gypsies first bring metal and magnifying glasses in the beginning of the book. Then towards the middle of the book, the new technologies are ships and railroads. Then towards the end of the book, we've come full circle because time has repeated itself, and we're back to gypsies bringing metal and magnifying glasses. Overall, the inclusion of these five major biblical allusions serves to emphasize and make more relatable the major themes of the novel, as well as support the idea that the novel can be seen as the Book of Macondo. The comparison to Eden emphasizes the innocence of the initial Macondo. The comparison to the Tree of Knowledge emphasizes the idea that so-called progress can actually lead to corruption. The comparison to Christ emphasizes Cab's importance in the story. The biblical-sized flood makes clear the purpose of the rain, and the nature of time being cyclical furthers the idea that the novel is the Bible for Macondo. Garcia Marquez incorporates these allusions with careful word choice and rich language. Overall, these biblical allusions corroborate the idea that 100 Years of Solitude was written as the Book of Macondo, and these allusions serve as the basis for one of the greatest pieces of literature today. Thank you.
A couple of questions, and then we'll move on to the next presentation.
These five allusions are some of the biggest allusions, and they're also probably allusions that many readers are familiar with. For example, Christ is one that most readers know, even if they're not Christian, probably. And the Garden of Eden and Noah's Flood are also very famous, so to speak, allusions. And by including them, he is furthering the idea that the novel is the Book for Macondo, which is one of the basis for his novel. So I think this is why he included.
Do you think, what would be the biggest thing that Marquez would lose from his book if he didn't include any of these allusions?
Well, I think the allusions are so unique to the book, and at the end we find out that the novel was actually sort of the Bible for Macondo, and I think if he hadn't included these allusions, it would be hard to support this idea that the novel is actually the Bible for Macondo, so I think he would lose quite a lot if he had not included them in the first place.
All right, you are done. Thank you.